Taking Control with Dr. Josh.
Well, welcome back. It's easy to get in an argument with a loved one and say things you may regret later. Small arguments can lead to big problems down the road, both at home and at work. Joining us today with some tips on healthy arguing is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klapo. Thanks so much for being here.
Sure.
Okay, what is healthy argument? Because arguing to me is just, ugh. So what's healthy?
We all know that communication is really important in a relationship, right?
Right.
Disagreements and arguments are a form of communication, and they have to happen in relationship. The problem is, it's kind of a volatile form of communication, right? It's dangerous. It can spiral out of control. And the problem there is when it does, couples of any kind develop feelings of resentment, contempt for each other, and that's when relationships get into big trouble. So you have to know how to argue in a way that doesn't destroy your relationship.
Okay, so how do you argue?
Well, there's sort of a roadmap or a skill set that you have to follow. Now, one of the first things we actually talked about last week, this idea of keeping your cool.
Okay.
If you feel that the blood is sort of boiling over, you're in no position to get into an argument or disagreement. It is much better to walk away for a couple minutes or even maybe a day, calm down, because you can't have an argument that way when you're that upset. That's
so,
the first step.
Okay, so like if you're upset, just say, okay, I'm real upset about this, I'll bring it up later.
You have to, because otherwise you're not going to think rationally.
Okay.
All right, next step is to what we call soften the startup. A lot of times you get in an argument, you just want to jump into that argument and start throwing the accusations. You need to say things like, hey, can we talk about this? Or I don't think we're on the right page, or we're not on the same page. Things like that, because otherwise the other person is going to get very defensive. And again, your argument will go essentially nowhere. So soften that start.
Yeah, but what do you do if you say, you know, can we talk about something? And the other person's like, what is there to talk about?
Then you back off.
Oh.
And you have, because again, the whole point is if the emotions are raging, it's not going to happen.
Okay, and you also say don't be a mind reader.
Yeah, this is something we all make mistakes. We assume that we know what the other person is thinking and why the argument happened. You got to focus on what you know. So here's how I see the situation, and then you got to be able to say, how do you see it? Not here's what I think you're thinking, because that never resolves the argument.
And then think before you speak.
Yeah.
It only takes a second to say something. You're like, oh, why did I just say that?
Well, you say it and then you say you're sorry, right? And the problem
is
it's already impacted the argument. So before you say something, really think, what's the implication if I say this? Not just in terms of hurting the other person's feelings, but again, resolving the argument.
Okay, and repair before exiting.
To kiss and make up, but this is to say at the end of that argument, you need to send a signal that you're on the same team, that this is an argument and this is not a relationship destruction sort of interaction, because a lot of times couples forget that and they turn an argument into a big problem. So let the person know, hey, look, you know, we're on the same team, we may not agree.
Now, how do you deal with difficult people at work who, you know, it's real quick to want to say what you think, and you're not in love with those people, so what do you do there?
Here's the neat thing. If you think about all of the things we just talked about, and it's not necessarily a loved one, it works. It works for them too, because it's about having disagreements, whether that is a person you're in love with or a person you're working with. If you don't know how to have those disagreements in a productive way, it will ruin any relationship, not just a love relationship.
Yeah, and you know, I've always heard, when in terms of relationships, especially if you're married, if you don't have arguments, something's wrong, because that means you're not communicating, right?
You got it.
Argument is still a form of communication.
Circles all the way back to where we started on this, which is communication is critical. All kinds of communication, as long as they're done in a healthy way.
Okay, so Dr. Josh, there's something we need to talk about after the show.
Okay.
Okay, I feel better now that we've already had this talk. Now we're leading in the right way.
No problem.
All right, Dr. Josh, thank you. Kaylee?